RGB split is a cool effect used in the compositing stage in 3D graphics creation after rendering the base image. You can use a slight displacement of the color channels in moderation to subtly enhance your render. It sharpens the image when there is harsh contrast between elements, as you can see on the border between the white text and the background of the image playing on your screen right now. Or you turn it up some to go funky! This gives your render a very cool look and can be used for psychedelic effects or distortion and glitch effects. Or you use it to the max over the top for some really tripped out psychedelic look on your render. Well, my name is Chris. I record this for ToxicTuber.net. Let me be your teacher for the next few minutes while you learn how to use that compositing effect in Blender, and then we'll build a reusable RGB split node group out of that node setup. So let's get right into it. To see the RGB split, we need to actually render something, preferably something with a sharp contrast. I used a demo file from the intro to demonstrate how to build the RGB split node group, and if you want to be a lazy bastard that doesn't learn anything, you can of course download the complete demo file from my Gumroad or my Patreon page. Links to that are in the video description. In this example, the white colors are a harsh contrast compared to the fully saturated and darker colors all around it. You can also use a white emission shader on a cube with a black background. This works as well and makes adding the RGB split node group to your startup file later a lot easier. Push F12 to render the image and then switch to the compositing workspace in Blender. This preset has all the windows we need at hand. Eventually you have to tick the Use Nodes checkbox to even see the nodes. Maybe this is on by default in newer Blender versions, but it could be off. And enable the backdrop function to see the render result displayed behind the nodes. Ctrl+Shift+Left-click on the render layers node gives you a preview of that node or any other node in the node setup you click like this. For this to work, of course you need to enable Node Wrangler. Node Wrangler is a very useful add-on and comes with Blender. Go to Edit, Preferences, Add-ons and search for Node and enable Node Wrangler. Another useful Node Wrangler function is Shift and holding the right mouse button while dragging the mouse over two noodles connected to the same output of a node. This adds the junction to this node setup. Now we are all set up and can start building the RGB split node setup. Hit Shift A to bring up the Add menu, and of course we start by adding a converter separate RGB node. Drag it right into the node stream. This node shows the red, green and blue channels as black and white values from 0 to 1 and also the alpha channel, but we don't have that in this image. Bring in a converter combine RGB node and put it after this separate RGB node. Connect all color channels straight on, or you will have mixed up colors. This should result in the same image as before. But now we can manipulate and play around with each color channel individually. Add in a distort translate node and place it on the connection of a color channel. Duplicate the translation node with Shift D and place a translation node on every color channel connection. Basically, this is all you need for the RGB split effect to work. Play around with the sliders to see it in action. But of course, we can do better than that. We want to put the whole node setup into a node group to have it organized and to make it easier to reuse the whole node group. So, select all the node groups in the setup and hit Ctrl G to put them all into one group with input and output. Now it gets a bit repetitive, but we need to connect every X and Y displacement factor to the input node. Each one of these values goes to the new appearing empty node socket on the group input node. Connect them in order to not confuse yourself. Press N to open the right side panel and select the group option. And of course, here we rename all the input to a more meaningful name, so you know what you are doing when tweaking these sliders. RGB, of course, stands for red, green and blue channel, so name the X and Y displacement of these channels accordingly. Control Tab lets you exit the node group. By pressing just Tab on a selected node group, lets you enter the node group and edit things inside it. This node group works now already. You can play around with the sliders and create interesting new color compositions and mix colors. To make life easier for you, select the node group, press F2 and rename it to RGB Split. Renaming the data block of the node group as well helps you finding that specific node group when appending it to another file. When you crank up the values of the group node too high, you can see that this color channel is moved to one side or the other, and Blender does not know what is outside of the image frame, and thus you have ugly dark borders at the border of your image. To fix this, you can add a distort scale node and scale the whole image by a very low amount. There's no fixed value for this, or maybe there is some math to it, but it's faster to just try some very low numbers. My final tip for this tutorial video is to append this node group straight to your Blender startup file. I did this and don't have to append it each and every time now. I have a lot of stuff in this file to actually see the effect while working on it, so I don't want to save this file as my startup file. So save this Blender project, open a new file, click on File, Append and navigate to this project file. Click through to the node tree RGB Split, that's why we renamed the data block, and append it. You can now find this node group in the Shift-A menu under Groups and the name you gave it. Click the shield icon next to the node group name to shield it from being deleted by making it a fake user. But we are keeping it real here. So go to File, Defaults and click on Save Startup File. And confirm this by clicking Again. I didn't record this here, but you should switch back to the Layout workspace, as Blender also saves the current workspace you're in into your startup file. Well, keep in mind you can also keyframe these values on the node group, and then that's all there is to know about using RGB splits in your compositing inside Blender. If you like this tutorial, leave a like, subscribe to the channel, ring the bell, and look around the channel for more interesting tutorials and crazy artworks that I might explain in future tutorials. And most of all, have fun using Blender. See you on the other side. TT out.